Hamza, 11.
Everyone knows I'm in a wheelchair, but I go all over the place so that I can encourage others to go out and be themselves and live like everyone else.
This ability. Episode 1, Jordan. Ahmad, 14.
I go to school and I study.
Sami, 16.
Before my injury, I liked playing football. Now, I play basketball.
Sami plays basketball with a wheelchair. Eman, 17.
Painting allows me to express what's inside me. I have a goal, I have strength, I have determination. It's stuck in my head and no one can change that.
Za'atari refugee camp, Abdel Majid, UNICEF Jordan.
In Za'atari, there are a lot of children with disabilities. There are those who have disabilities from birth, and there are so many others who actually got their disabilities from war injuries.
Iman adjusts her prosthetic leg.
When I first arrived, it was really hard. I didn't have crutches or a prosthetic leg. I used a wheelchair.
Sami uses his wheelchair in the camp.
One big challenge were the toilets. There were no toilets in the houses. We had to go to communal toilets. It was hard for me to get to them. My father had to carry me. It made me feel uncomfortable.
UNICEF have provided individual households with toilets, and we actually targeted the children and the people with disabilities, upgrading their toilets into having them more suited for to be used by children with disabilities.
Can your wheelchair go over this?
No.
What should we do?
Flatten all this out with concrete.
In order for me to be independent, there should be a ramp and something to hold to lift myself up.
A construction crew works on the toilet.
I'll be able to go to the bathroom with my wheelchair.
Ahmed's father.
They went above and beyond in their work when they saw his situation. For example, if it was supposed to be 60 centimeters long, they made it a bit longer, just for Ahmed.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The first thing I'm going to do is get down on the ground and look at the ceramic floor, because I've never seen one before. I'll take the wheelchair on the ceramic and wash my hands and everything. I think it's going to be a blast.
UNICEF have also fitted all the centers with accessible toilets, and it meant that children can actually access services that were not accessible before. Most of the children who now have access to the services, wash services, they became better off psychologically. Those children, once they were closed down, they wouldn't go out and interact with the world. They wouldn't go out and make friends. They wouldn't go out and actually benefit from the multiple services that UNICEF have for them, education-wise, protection-wise, entertainment. Their psychology has changed. Now they're happier.
Sami throws the basketball.
This one is about every person who has lost a part of themselves.
Iman displays her paintings.
I want to keep painting and learning more so that I can teach others how to paint, how to acquire skills, and maybe instead of Syria being covered in ash and darkness, it will be covered in bright colors.
I have a lot of ideas for things to build.
Hamza's brother watches Mr. B.
I made a mobile phone holder so we can watch videos.
Ahmed uses his phone with his feet.
It used to be difficult for my son to get around. Then one day we visited some relatives, They had a kind of bicycle with six wheels. We put him on and he managed to control it. He held on and just took off.
Ahmed rides his bike with his friends.
I feel normal. Like a normal person.
Hamza brings home drinks for the construction crew.
Now I've seen these engineers who think about people with disabilities, I'm inspired to be just like them and to build a new future. One that does not discriminate whether or not you have a disability, because you have to think about everyone.
UNICEF for every child. Baby shark did 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 baby shark did 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 daddy shark did 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 daddy shark did did did. Hamza sings with Abbott.